Hi, my name is Laura Manhill, Stewardship and Education Program Director at Friends of the Mississippi River. We're a St. Paul-based nonprofit working to protect and restore the Mississippi River and its watershed. Today, we're going to tell you about a program that educates people about storm drain stenciling as well as water quality education. Chances are you've already used water at least once today, whether it was for washing, cleaning, drinking, or playing. Water that comes from the Mississippi River to our taps goes through one system and it's treated at a plant. So it takes a journey from the river to a plant, to your tap, into your home, and then back down the drain and back to the plant to be treated before it goes back into the Mississippi River. Now that is only one waterway system. There's a completely different system when it rains on our rooftops, our parking lots and streets and runs into the river. The water is not treated at all. Unfortunately, that's called runoff pollution. On its way down to the river, it picks up many contaminants such as soil, trash, and oil products. Think about what you see on the streets that can wash into the river with all that water.
Hi, my name is Sam Armacost. I am the Stewardship and Education Program Associate at Friends of the Mississippi River. Cigarette butts are tied with salt for the worst pollutants in the metro area. It is one of the most littered plastic pollutants in the entire world. It is estimated that 2/3 of the trillions of cigarettes that are produced each year get tossed into the natural environment. Because they are small, light, and easily fit down a drain, they go into the drain, the paper dissolves, but then all of the toxic chemicals inside can flow into the river, flow into the water sources, and last for over 10 years. Thousands of these cigarettes go down the river each year, each season, and end up in the ocean.
Chloride, or salt, is commonly used as a de-icer in winter. Unfortunately, it's also been posing risks to aquatic life and drinking water as salt levels have increased in lakes and rivers across Minnesota in the last few winters. Tied with cigarettes for the top pollutant coming from the metro area, increasing levels of salt pose risks to aquatic life such as fish and plants and wildlife. With increasing levels of salt, fish and plants are not adapted to those living conditions. Every year, more and more bodies of water are listed as impaired due to increasing levels of salt.
Oil doesn't mix with water. So for example, when motor oil goes down a drain and into a waterway, it creates a film on the surface of the water. So then, fish catching insects or birds catching fish, when they go into the water, they come out covered in this oil.
Antifreeze is in our car radiators and is very poisonous to people and animals. If you notice a spill, clean it up immediately with an absorbent material such as sawdust or even baking soda, and then dispose of it immediately. It can also contaminate groundwater. When stormwater runoff is absorbed into the soil, it is filtered and ultimately replenishes aquifers or flows into streams and rivers. Stormwater runoff can also introduce pollution problems such as sediment, nutrients, bacteria, and trash that are washed into our river. This may look like trash to you, but small pieces of trash can end up looking like food to wildlife. They eat it and can't digest it, and then can end up starving to death.
Yard waste, like leaves and grass, can clog our storm drains. When they do make their way into the waterway, they can release things like phosphorus and nitrogen, which act as a fertilizer for algae. With algae blooms, there can be a decrease in oxygen in the water and an increase in toxins that affect both humans and wildlife.
Dirt and soil from construction sites and people redoing their yards can be carried away by stormwater into the river, making the temperature warmer and the water darker. Changing the temperature of the water can negatively impact the fish and wildlife that live there.
Animals have bacteria in their stomach that can make humans really sick. If you've ever had a favorite swimming hole be closed in the summertime, this is often a reason. You can do your part by picking up your pet's waste. Increased sediment, nutrients, and other pollutants are harmful to water quality. They threaten drinking water sources and impact the water treatment processes. Unfortunately, due to climate changes, including more frequent and intense storms, more extreme flooding events, drought conditions, and lower stream flow can make all these problems worse by concentrating pollutants.
Storm drain stenciling is one way to educate the community about what happens to the water that goes down the storm drain.
It can help raise awareness of the potential impacts of our actions and keep harmful pollutants out of the water and out of our river.
Be a friend to the Mississippi River.